first date, we're going to be working on teaching the dog get it, leave it. And this will introduce a mark signal. The dog will get to go out to the target and get her treat. And then as soon as she swallows it, I'm going to tell her leave it and reward her for turning back to me. I consider leave it to be an attention command, and I expect the dog to give me focused eye contact when she hears it. Now, if your dog doesn't have to stay, you can just hold the dog in place. She has one, so I'm going to tell her to stay and go to the target. Good girl. Very nice. Good. Now, she knows the games, so she's giving me attention, but you should expect that a younger dog would be leaning forward and staring right at that tree. Get it. Leave it. Yes. Good girl. That's right. There. Good. Okay, let's try again. Here. Sit. Good work. Stay. That's good. Get it. Leave it. Yes. Good girl. And since there's no treat on there after she eats it, there's no reason for her to hang at that target, so the leave it command is easy for her to decide to obey. In the second game, we're going to reverse the order on this. This time, I'm going to place the treat, and if the dog looks, that's fine, I expect them to, and then I'm going to say leave it and wait for eye contact. Now, tricks will make this look easy, because she knows the game, but when you first teach this game, it often takes more than a minute, and I mean a real minute, before the dog accidentally looks at you. You do one leave it command, and you wait for eye contact, and you reward it. Don't bribe it. Stay. Girl. Excellent. Good. Now she's giving me voluntary eye contact, so I'm definitely going to reward that. And then she has a little look and comes back. So that shows you that she understands that the way to get to that tree is to give me attention. She gets the game. Good girl. She's not even needing to leave a command. Good girl. Now that she's giving me committed attention, leave it. Good. If I have committed attention, I then have the option of doing this. Get it. Come. Good girl. Very nice. Good job. And again, I get a chance to use my mark signal. She has a get it command. Yep. And then does a little recall. And how formal you get about the cuts and finishes will just depend on your dog's particular level of experience. That's a good girl. Okay. In this next set of exercises, we're going to be using two targets. This allows some dogs to find it much easier to choose to focus on the handler because the targets are going to be placed so the dog cannot look at both at the same time. Again, you're also looking for voluntary attention, and it's important to be observant and ready to praise and reward when it happens. What we're gonna do on the first exercise is do a setup, Trixio, that is quite useful for stabilizing stays. Huh? I think that in order to be fair to the dog, for this exercise to work, you need to have some duration on the sit stay, at least up to 30 seconds, although not particularly at great distance. It's important to have your correction installed. So whatever you're going to do, your dog makes an error about sit stay, they need to understand it. Hey, Trixie. Now, Trix understands that if I do upward collar pressure and tell her to sit, she should sit to turn it off. That's her correction. So as long as she understands that, then I am prepared to go ahead and play the game, and I know what I'm going to do about it if she finds a great position. Okay? So I'm going to tell her to stay. I'm going to keep my leash ready. I will not restrain her, but I will have the leash short enough so that if she makes a mistake and moves, I can stop her on the first step. I'm going to have a tree on this target, remind her to stay, and place it out to the side. Good girl. And if I had a less experienced dog, I might go ahead and reward that stay right there. I'm going to switch hands to stay. Excellent girl. Beautiful. And that's what I'm looking for, is that she holds her sit and she looks right at me. Initially, I'm going to reward her from my hand for doing that, then I'm going to watch it carefully because that will happen. I'll look to the targets. Looking is all right, looking is not. But I'm going to reward your machine turns focus to me. Yes, good girl. That's right. Good sit. Good. And I noticed that she looked to my left that time. She's going to be nice focused attention, so I'm going to send her to the target on my right and then do a recall. And this is the foundation skill for directed jumping. Get it? Come! Good girl. Very good. Excellent dog. Yep. Good heel. That's it. Good. That's the way. And even setting up for the exercise again this day, you have the opportunity to watch for the dog to try and cheat and go to one of the targets. Good girl. Yay! Good for you.